One of the things that a lot of our customers will ask about is calories, because this is not a low-calorie meal replacement. So many of them that have these miraculous, like, weight loss benefits, they're 100 calories, they're 120 calories. Ours is an unapologetic 400 calories.
Yeah, the justification that someone would have for making it very, very low calories, that they'll say, well, this is going to be a really effective weight loss tool. In the short term, it might, because you're going to be starving, but you will be starving. And that is an urge that, why fight it if you don't have to, is, I guess, one way of saying that. So we definitely lean into the fact that this is going to be a nourishing, satisfying meal, because you can't trick the body. The body knows if it's gotten energy. It's more than just, did something fill up my intestines and I'm full? No. So you can't trick it. We're not trying to. We fuel the body. We give it energy. But we also, by putting in the particular blend of macronutrients that we did, we help the body use that energy at the same time. So you're getting energy. You're using the energy. Because when you eat something that might have calories, but it's spiking your insulin up, then, and you see your glucose climb, it drops, and as it really plummets, the person starts to feel hungry again. We just sort of take all that off the table. When you drink Health Code Complete Meal, your blood glucose levels are just going to hum along like a flat line. You avoid all those peaks and troughs that so many people have to sort of suffer through, those highs and lows throughout the day, by really basing their macronutrients in the wrong direction. They've tipped it the wrong way.
One of the things that you still hear from so many people, including some, quote, experts, is about a calorie is a calorie is a calorie, regardless of the source. And the research just doesn't bear that out.
Yeah, a calorie has limited value when we really try to account for every single one, because the body metabolizes these energy sources very, very differently. That energy in those foods is not going to be the full-on available energy to the body, and more because there's an expense to digesting it and absorbing it. There's a metabolic demand just from that process alone. But moreover, it fails to account for what that calorie might do to your hormones. So now all of a sudden you eat one calorie from glucose, but that's spiking your insulin. You're more inclined to store that calorie as opposed to, say, one calorie from protein or fat. When you get very little or no insulin bump, the body won't store that calorie. It will use the calorie.
I mean, it's the notion of, I'm going to just drink this 400 calories of soda and believe that having 400 calorie serving of beef are somehow equal.
That's right. It's silly. On its face value, independent of the actual composition of micronutrients. When you are spiking your insulin with those calories, you will store those calories much more readily. If you're not spiking your insulin, you will simply use them.